Mocha Pro 2021 features the improved AdjustTrack Module, designed to help you correct drifting tracking data. The new AdjustTrack 2.0 takes the pain out of correcting difficult tracks with an easier-to-use interface and updated workflow. When tracked objects go off-screen, get obscured by foreground elements, or have motion blur, any track can be subject to drift. AdjustTrack adds a secondary level of interpolated keyframes, which enables the artist to quickly make non-destructive corrections over time. You can now adjust based on specific transforms with as many available reference points as you choose. New features also include auto-step correction, magnetic point snapping, and dynamic multi-point nudge adjustments. So let's get started with AdjustTrack in this quick overview. After tracking a shot, like this screen track, Mocha users typically look at the planar surface tool to see how accurately the track has been captured. Do note that AdjustTrack works best for drift, so if your track is woefully off base, the quicker solution is to look for occlusions and reflections that you can avoid and try again. However, for most difficult tracks, where you can only track a few parameters, AdjustTrack is clutch for locking the motion perfectly. Setting up reference points is the first step in correcting a track. Reference points work slightly differently in AdjustTrack in Mocha 2021. You can set them either as a template for the kind of adjustment you want, or add them yourself as needed. What this means is that you can think about how many points you need for what type of transform and then only use what you need. Each transform checkbox sets a different number of points when you click Set Points, and this is meant to be intuitive for the types of motion you need to correct, and is similar to using the parameter settings for Mocha planar tracking. Here's what I mean. Translation sets 1 point for X and Y translation only. Scale and rotation sets 2 points to rotate or scale between points. Shear sets 3 points for allowing shear adjustment. See how the points can now skew the track correction with a little bit of vertical and horizontal warp? You get the idea. Perspective sets 4 points for a full 4-point corner pin style perspective adjustment. After you have chosen the track type, click Set Points to create the points which you can then adjust manually. Adding new reference points also has better functionality, as now you can add multiple reference points wherever you like. Each new point contributes to the adjustment of the plane based on the position of the other points. You can select between the points using the cursor or cycle using the greater than and less than buttons. You want to position your points on easily identifiable areas. Once you are happy with the position of the points, click Set Reference Frame to define a frame to look at when adjusting forwards or backwards from that point. This is an important step because setting the reference frame is what the AdjustTrack module uses as a baseline correct placement for your points. Adjusting points for track correction is also pretty straightforward. Once you have set a reference frame, you can start moving through the timeline and adjusting points where they drift from their initial placement. I like to scroll through the timeline a few times to see where the drift is greatest and make my corrections where the drift is the most noticeable. Like rotoscoping, think of this as animating keyframes in traditional animation workflows. If we see drift, we can use the auto button in nudge controls to add an interpolated correction keyframe. Unlike the previous AdjustTrack, still found here under Classic, with AdjustTrack 2.0, each point adjustment sets a keyframe for every other point in the shot. And just like Classic AdjustTrack, you can see the original reference frame for the selected point in the zoom window in the upper left of the viewer and the current frame in the view window below that. While you are adjusting your points, you can click one of the surface view corners to see how the surface itself is adjusting to your changes. This is very helpful if you are planning on using the surface as your export and want to make sure it is still lining up properly. You can also still nudge points in order to adjust them by small degrees. You can now nudge diagonally, and you can press and hold the assigned button or shortcut key to nudge continuously. By default, nudge is set to the arrow keys, but you can change them according to your preferences in Keyboard Preferences. We have also added an auto nudge feature to the AdjustTrack 2.0 module. Auto nudge allows users to have Mocha automatically nudge points across the whole sequence in predefined steps. If using adjusted tracks to drive other layers, make sure to link to adjusted layer in the layer properties tab. To export adjusted data, you can export directly out of the module to file in a variety of host formats, or simply copy and paste to your favorite host. To learn more about Mocha Pro 2021's new features and download a free trial, visit us at www.boriseffects.com, where you can find free tutorials, live training events, support forums, and so much more.